We studied knuckle cracking because it's a very common and controversial topic. In particular, 25 to 50% of people identify themselves as knuckle crackers at some point in their lives. People come in all the time asking whether knuckle cracking is going to cause arthritis. But they keep doing it because it gives them a feeling of relief from tension. Our study was the first one that synced up what we heard and what we saw at the same time. So we were using real-time ultrasound to look at the joint as it popped. And what we found was something that looked to us like the 4th of July, a tiny firework explosion in the joint that occurred every time. Very distinctive, very unusual. We know that this appearance is caused by gas or bubbles forming in the joint. We found consistently that the sound came before the flash that we see of the bubble coming into the joint. So there's dissolved gas in the joint fluid that gets liberated, and it's actually that bubble formation that's associated with the pop, not the bubble popping like a balloon. There was a recent study out of Canada earlier this year that got a lot of press. It looked at one person cracking his knuckles in an MRI scanner. Now, MRI isn't as fast and can't see things as small as ultrasound, but in that study, they actually were able to visualize in that one individual the process of knuckle cracking. So that was very interesting. What we were able to do is look at knuckle cracking much more quickly, look at much more detail, and also to listen to the sound of the crack at the same time as watching the joint, which they were not able to do with MRI. We have an intense interest in musculoskeletal imaging and caring for patients with orthopedic issues. So we really wanted to know for our patients whether it was causing any problems or not to be knuckle cracking. We really are well positioned here at UC Davis to have a multidisciplinary team. So we've got the hand specialist, the orthopedist, we've got the diagnostic imaging specialist, and we've got the great equipment. We looked at 400 knuckles in a very detailed way, asking people about any problems with their knuckles or upper extremities. We asked about any symptoms, weakness, swelling, any problems with their hands in general. What we'd like to do now is expand it to look at thousands of people with a survey worldwide. One piece of advice is that people sometimes don't like their coworkers and family members to knuckle crack. So that's been an interesting recurring story that we've heard. However, we haven't found any short-term adverse effects of knuckle cracking. So it may be irritating to others, but not to the joints that are being cracked.